I specifically work in an organization which is very young. The average age is 32 years. The average tenure of employees is less than 4 years. So obviously the churn is very high. Like Unmesh pointed out that you have an organization where the engagement is really high, but also the attrition is very high. And how do you solve for that? How do you first make sense out of it? And how do you find a solve for that? So this is the problem we were facing a couple of years back. And you know, when you ask them in annual surveys, you get great results and people are super happy, they are super engaged, they feel ownership to the brand, they are passionate, they are creative, but they're also leaving the organization in average 10 years or 3.5 and 4 years. So what's going wrong there? And that's where we actually took help of technology to help us understand and decode this problem.
Can you help me? You know, it sounds a little oxymoronish when you're saying you work for a small company where I think it's easy for you to just throw your arm around literally every employee, know the person by name, and understand what he or she essentially wants and how can you make it a lot more meaningful for that person. And then you're deploying technology, which instead of sometimes taking you closer, is taking you further away, because now maybe there is a chat box between you and that person might actually just be sitting about a few meters away from where you are. Do you need that chat box?
Very interesting. Yes, we are just about 300 people in the office, very, very small organization. We all sit in one building, mostly. 200 people sit in one building. There are 100 people who are sitting in another building. So you would say, yeah, everybody knows everybody, and it's very easy to gauge a mood of an organization. But at the same time, why would we have such a high attrition if people are happy, seemingly? And that's when we deployed the chatbot, and that was precisely the reason we took help of technology. So we have an AI chatbot called Amber in the office, and she talks to you like a real person. In fact, I think maybe 40% of the people don't even know that she is not real. It's very intuitive kind of a chat that happens. So what we are right now trying to solve for, you know, we've already done automation in terms of HRMS. We've already used technology wherever technology needed to be used in terms of automation. But what we are trying to now solve for is the next level of technology, which is a predictive analysis. And what this chatbot has really helped us to really gauge is the real mood of the organization. Even though, you know, you might be doing a lot of parties and people are seemingly having fun at workplace and there's music and everything, but what is the employee really feeling inside? How is the employee dealing with a stress from a manager on a day-to-day basis? How is the employee feeling that their growth path is in the organization? Are they getting the learnings that they want to get? So these were a lot of these drivers which came out in a chatbot to us. And you would say that why can't these employees tell you on a one-on-one meeting? It's true that people don't really share everything when you ask them in a one-on-one meeting. Maybe there are certain biases. Maybe some things come out only when there are anonymous surveys. And that's what is really helping us, you know, to get into the predictive behaviors of these employees. We've actually tried to solve a lot of these issues like retention of, you know, key talents, predicting when somebody might be leaving, predicting which functions might be facing bigger challenges than other functions, and hence, does it require a leadership level intervention, et cetera, et cetera. So all of this is happening, and it's happening in real time, not at the end of the year with an annual survey.
You know, I would bet 100% of the 40% of the people who think that she chatbox is not for real are men.
My question is to Ms. Manisha, where she has mentioned that they have deployed Amber in the organization. So how does Amber is helping you out to retaining the people in your organization, and what is the confidentiality level of those feedback which you are getting it out from the employees?
And do you want a gender cut of how Amber is influencing male versus female? I'm just joking. I'm sorry for that. Please go ahead.
So we launched Amber 2 years back. So firstly, the engagement level was about 85%. So Amber team told us that this is one of the highest engagements that they've seen in any organization, which means that people had so much to share. Secondly, our mood scores were really good, but yet there were key drivers that we were low on. For example, one of the key drivers that was constantly coming up to us as a problem area was growth opportunities for people. Now, of course, I mean, this is one thing where no employee will today say that I have great growth opportunities in any organization, but that made us think a little bit more on this particular aspect and create some very some new initiatives which helped solve that problem for us. And we see that driver kind of improving as we go along. There were a few other cases where we had some department-led issues cropping up, which could be related to certain managers and leaders, and which also we tried to solve. Regarding confidentiality, it's the information that comes to us is only available to very, very selected team of people. The employees are aware who this information is reaching to, and that's about it. So the information is not shared with managers or even with business heads, unless there is something that is affecting the whole business unit. So this information is kept only at the HR and the CEO level. There are some certain dashboards which you can share with your business heads in case you want to involve them in certain interventions. But there would be no employee level feedback or information which is shared with anyone. So that is completely confidential.